Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to ACL Melbourne 2015. Dr. Curry joined by Benny Sims. Benny, went to round three here of the pool play for the competition between all the teams competing in Advanced Warfare, Call of Duty, of course. Now, Ryzen up against TextBook. Both of these teams have played already. Ryzen, we saw them on the main stage. They did get defeated 2-1 to the Ambition squad. It must be noted, though, they did actually perform quite well in the final map there, so it will be interesting to see if, since we've seen them on the main stage, they've managed to improve a little.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, they fell a little bit short 2-1, but they were able to secure that search and destroy pretty comfortably. We're going to jump straight into this game, no mucking around here, and it's going to be a hard point retreat. So as you did say, it is TextBook Gaming up against the team of Ryzen, and we're going to start off with Lucer. He had a really good series last game. Let's see what he can do off the break.
All right, first hill is going to be open territory, so players are going to be battling for the spawns and control. Coming to rotation for the following hills here, Lucifer just wants to place the lower side here. Doesn't find any of the players. Their first points will go in favor of TextBook, and that's going to be first blood drawn by Tates. Now Temper in the hill, can't finish off Tates, and that's going to be three kills down. Ryzen not able to break in the first setup.
Yeah, certainly. Really good start coming down the team of TextBook. Look at Tates. Starting off extremely well. Ooh. Four kills to his name already. Who said this man is old? He is going off. He's showing how these young kids should use those sticks there, as he unfortunately does get taken down. But nice little start for the team of TextBook there, as they are 9-3 currently, as I say that. Bacon picks up a nice little two-piece in the background, so we are on board with Temper. Picks up a one kill there, and he's going to get contested straight away in this hard point from the locker section there and dies straight away.
Yeah, good to see Ryzen being able to break that. Tate, as you said, he's hit the ground running right there. Lots of motivation to perform well coming to this event. They have high expectations. Talking to the boys before competing this morning, they wanted a top four finish, and they're performing quite well at this stage. You do see Braxton 4-1, so everyone from TextBook right now pulling their weight.
Yeah, as you said, TextBook has started off really, really, really strong here, as we are on board with Lucifer here, just holding the turtle hardpoint. Nades coming in everywhere. He's getting a little bit of protection from your team, but unfortunately does get taken down by Bacon there, who picks up a two-piece. Nice little break from the team of TextBook there, as they do get three down, as Brax able to pick up that final kill there, as the players from Rise or Ryzen are spawning over that lobby section.
Yeah, it is interesting to note the difference in KD between the two teams, yet somehow the scoreboard is still equal. But it is early days, it's only been 2 minutes, and it will be the team of TextBook that will lock down this statue hardpoint. You do see the spawns coming out though, so Ryzen, they should be able in 20 seconds to just hold the middle map there, get the preferred spawns leading into the lobby hill here, and maybe they can pull back and make an even scoreline.
Yeah, as you said, what a great start from the team of TextBook, but they're not really stretching that lead out. You look at the slain at the top right, and you've got Tates 10-3 with Brax 8-1, currently out ammo, goes for the play with the knife, but his teammates able to...
He's just stalking
him. No, he's just picks up an ASM, one, able to pick up the kill, and Brax is going absolutely off on a 5-kill streak, going 9-1, and they've stretched that lead out to over 24 points. Unfortunately, they don't have the rotation here, but let's see whether they're able to break it. We are on board with Brax here. We'll spot a player on the left-hand side. Unfortunately, the player does get taken down, but just like that, they do break the hard point, so the team at TextBook are looking extremely strong at this point.
Yeah, Ryzen, they've managed to dedicate 20 seconds to set up that hill, and it has not worked out for them. Jewelo, nice little double there, tagging up the third player. He'll calm that out, and it will get cleaned up. Tates, though, he is on a mission right now, 13-4, just slaying his heart out right now, as he does actually get taken down. Nice two-piece by Lucifer. Challenges inside the hill will drop, though. Good defense by TextBook, and they're just extending that lead to a solid margin now.
Yes, certainly. As you see, the slain is going in favor of the TextBook, but let's jump on board with Ryzen and see what they're doing wrong. As we do see the early rotation, they did rotate early against the true Ambition team, but it looks like it's going to be a little bit more difficult against a team like TextBook Gaming here, as we do see Temper pick up one. Does get spotted there, jumps up and down. Unfortunately, gets a couple of shots off, but does get tagged up himself. Ooh. Eventually does get taken down by Brax there, and just like that, the team of TextBook Gaming are able to break it.
Yeah, doing extremely well. Tates has actually slowed down. That three deaths in a row without getting a kill there. Hopefully he can pull it back, but it is... four captures to his name, doing a wonderful job at the OBJ. But look at Temper. He's been running in the hill with Lucifer. Both of them on the six captures. Braxton overextending will get the spawners. It is a challenged hill. They spot out the player who actually gets a kill. Good job by Lucifer. Gets the second player too, but does drop. So good work by him, not allowing TextBook to get those points.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, Lucifer was able to pick up a couple of crucial kills in that hard point, which didn't enable the team at TextBook to stretch out the lead. And at this current stage, it's all been TextBook, but they're only 40 points up. So somehow the team have risen, been able to keep in this, as we see Tates pick up a nice little kill. His teammate gives him a little bit of cover there, and they were able to shut the team of Ryzen's push.
Once again, Textbook, they're going to get the scrap time here in this hill, and they're going to try and get the rotations here. Ryzen dedicating a lot of time to these setups, but they just can't hold on to it. Textbook doing a wonderful job at recovering hills. Here comes a rotation in. Three players set up in the lobby, one in the hill. It will be Tampa. Here come the players from Textbook. They're going to be funneling on in. Good shot there by Tampa. Doesn't move from the location, though. Might need to start a bit of movement here, because here come the exo abilities through the corners. Goes for a very questionable reload at that time. Tates does break it, but drops. Good job by Ryzen, though. This is the first real hold that they've done throughout the game.
Yes, certainly, as you said, and they're only 30 points down, and they're getting a little bit of control of this hard point. We are going to jump on board with Lucifer, who's able to pick up one, but unfortunately does get taken down by Bacon there, and he's playing extremely well, 16 and 17, so he's doing all the slaying for his team at this current stage, but no one's giving him any support at all, as Brax picks up a nice little two-piece there, just running that bell there, controlling the back stairs. Unfortunately, a bit of COD timing there, and he wasn't able to pick up the player that did push the back stairs, but his teammate's able to pick up the kill, and Brax going on a four kill streak, or as I say, that does get taken down, but 20 and 9.
Good job by Tampa there to break it. Actually gets a triple there, and that's going to be a four down. So they will get the scrap time here, and that hill has managed to make the scoreline a little bit less favorable towards Textbook. Good job by the guys at Ryzen. Now, it is roughly 20, 30 second differential between these two teams. It's roughly been that through the whole first rotation. But here comes the final 5 minutes here. Back to the middle hard point here. This is where we saw Textbook get that first instance of a lead. Let's see if they can do it again.
Yes, certainly, as you said. And Textbook are currently about plus 20 so kills up at this stage, and they're only 30 points up. So the rotations coming out of the team of Risen must be doing extremely well, as we see Julo, unfortunately, does get taken down there by Lucifer, as Senki's able to pick up. Looks like it was Tate's there. And the team of Textbook, yet again, just controlling that half point, not allowing Risen to get any control, as we will jump on board with Bacon, see what he's able to do, as he's going to push this through hard point, as Julo and himself are both in the hard point.
Looking at the score, we notice no one from Ryzen is actually in the positive. The closest is Lucifer, who does have that 20 for 22 KD ratio. Meanwhile, on the opposite, Braxton, Tate, both of them going off. Julo doing a wonderful job at breaking hills, and we saw Bacon pick up several two pieces to regain control of the hills. Wonderful job by Textbook.
Yeah, certainly, as you said. But we got an early rotation coming out of the team of Risen here, as they have been doing throughout the whole last series and previous games. And three down for the team of Textbook. So that's the first time. Make that a team down, as we do say that. So it looks like Risen actually got a little bit of control here. They're controlling those spawns. And look where the team of Textbook are spawning here. So hopefully they're able to capitalize on this. And a team kill coming through from Brax, who did take out his teammate. And they're getting some valuable time. It's under 16 points now as we speak. Oh, this is the closest we've been. But you said four down straight away.
Just as easy as that for the guys at Textbook. Let's see if they can hold the final 30 seconds here. Very crucial time. But good job by Lucifer to take out Braxton. Now there's going to be Julo up against him. He's got some shaky shots and gets taken out in the back. Good job by Senku there and tagging up. But Bacon, once again, getting those two pieces that we just discussed. What can Manning do? Not much, unfortunately. Good job by Tates there. And once again, Textbook get that scrap time.
Yeah, certainly. And they're going to stretch that lead out to over 30 points, as you did say, picking up the final 5 seconds here, as Bacon will be uncontested. He's only got 19 kills to his name, but he's getting some valuable kills, as you have mentioned multiple times throughout this game here. Getting a lot of two pieces and so forth. He's going to be looking for these spawns. He's able to pick up that player there. But look at the spawns coming out of Risen. They are spawning back cave here, so they're going to be able to contest this hill pretty easily, as Bacon's just looking for those kills in the hard point. Unfortunately, does get taken down by Lucifer there. And that's two down for both sides here, as the hill is getting contested quite heavily, as Tempest is jumping up and down. He needs to pick up these kills. There's only 2.5 minutes remaining, 30 seconds on this last hard point, and they're 30 points down.
Textbook, they're not stressed about this contested hill. They have the lead. It's just this isn't points that are going towards Ryzen, so they're happy to contest it, and even if they can break it, even better. Lucifer, he's got to get this kill, though, and he actually misses there. That's another two-piece to Bacon. Spots a third play outside the door. He's going to calm that to his teammate. Braxton will clean it up, and here comes the contestant once again. Very good shots there, but gets the life slapped out of him, though. Bacon doing a wonderful job.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, Bacon doing some very important kills throughout this game. We've gotten the last 2 minutes as the rotation does come down. Lucifer decides to pick up those last couple of seconds, which might come in handy near the end of the game here. They're only 35 points down, as we do see Tempo in the hard point first up. He knows where they're spawning. Unfortunately, does get taken down by Tate, who picks up a nice little two-piece there. And you've got to give him a little bit of credit, 31 and 20. But still, it's anyone's game, as Senkai's able to pick up a kill there. And I'm not sure whether they're controlling these spawns at all. They're looking at the same direction as the team of Textbook Gamer are trying to get those spawns in favour for the next hard point here, as he's going to get pushed by three players, as we see through the quad vision there. And we will go control of the team of Risen. So they're actually holding this out, and with under a minute and a half left, they're still within this game.
Yeah, they just managed to keep pull it back through these hills. It's really interesting, because you just look at the KD ratios and you'd think the Textbook would be more an advantage at this situation as they do get the three down. 14 seconds left in this hill. Here comes the rotation though to the final hill. Back to the second lobby room here. Braxton will be able to once again get the final few seconds here. The point differential between these two teams, Ryzen, they got to lock this down. They're doing it currently. They can actually still win this.
Yeah, and as you said, very crucial rotation coming out of Lucifer there. He's able to pick up that kill, but he's going to get contested. He's the last one alive. Jumps up and down. Does get tagged up there quite heavily, so they're going to know he's one shot. Does pick up the kill there, and he's going to look for that second. Unfortunately, I think he should have stayed down a little bit there. He needs a little bit of support from his teammate. And with 30 seconds left in this game, the first map will be going in favor of Textbook Gaming as they're able to clinch this out. Despite they did outslay the team of Risen, they didn't actually win quite comfortably. I think they lost about 20-odd kills with Brax about to drop that 40 bomb. We'll jump on board with him, see whether he can. Currently on 39 kills. Does look for that 40th. Does get a couple of tags out and decides to back off with 14 seconds left. Go for those kills, Brax. Try and get that 40 bomb, mate. And he's going to get a couple of shots off. Doesn't pick up the player there. And he's still struggling. He will eventually pick up that 40 kill there. And with him going 40 and 26, they comfortably take that lead by about 60 points. But within a couple of rotations left, it could have gone anyone's way. So I was surprised that the team of Risen were able to keep that close throughout that series there, Curry.
Yeah, they did quite a reasonable job. You can tell just there by looking at the captures. Lucify, 16, Temper, 15. So lots of OBJ work done by Ryzen constantly. We saw Temper actually being the first one in the hill, always on the early rotations there. But you got to just question. They did leave a lot of scrap time towards the end of the hills, rotating around 20 seconds, 15 seconds or so. That might have, you know, come back to haunt them in the end there.
Yeah, and they did that against True Ambition, I believe it was, Serenity also. And they were able to lose that hard point too. As you said, they give up that last 15, 20 seconds. And you can't really be doing that against these sort of teams. They're going to capitalize on that. And then they break the hill so easily. So Ryzen were able to control those last, you know, 10 seconds or so. But, yeah, as you said, unfortunately, they weren't able to take that win as Textbook comfortably win by 60 points in the end. It was a close series, but they were able to walk away quite convincingly.
Ryzen, fairly new to the Australian competitive Call of Duty scene. You could also see that through the way that they were playing. You know, reloading mid-hill when they're getting pushed by players.
Twice,
Several times we saw Temper doing that. Also, just, you know, the whole rotations. Not really understanding, you know, the importance of the scrap time. Of course, you do eventually learn. Every LAN event is a good learning experience, so these guys, are, you know, you can tell they're already adapting compared to the first series that we saw up against the team of True Ambition, where it was, you know, a little bit shaky for the first few seconds, getting used to that LAN environment, that LAN setting. Of course, it is entirely different playing on a LAN connection compared to online.
Yeah, that is correct, Curry. And we're going to have Detroit uplink, and I'm very impressed with the Detroit from these guys in the uplink in comeback before. Mm-hmm. They played off extremely well. Unfortunately, they lost the last couple of minutes there, which gave the win to True Ambition. So let's see whether they can get their composure. We're going to jump straight into this game. As we did say, it is uplink Detroit. And we're going to start off with the team from Risen and see what they can do off the break here, as we will start off with Senkai. He's going to be pushing this little flank here. Let's see if he's able to pick up a couple of kills and pick up that flank, as he does contest against Tate. He's able to pick that up. So the team of Textbook Gaming obviously aware where Senkai is, but doesn't surprise them as they do pick up the satellite drone and throw it into the base for the team there, as Armani picks up one, and that's three down for the team of Textbook. So some good defense coming out of the team of Risen, and they're able to stop that push early on.
Players to watch from the team of Risen in this uplink, I'm going to say Lucifer and Temper, both of them 16 OBJ. It was actually 16 for Lucifer, 15 kill captures for those players. So I'd like to see their OBJ work in a new game mode, especially one where it basically revolves around team communication and rotations. It will be Bacon getting those classic two pieces that he's known for right now. In comes a player from Ryzen who just picks up the ball and throws it out towards Garage side here. It's a bit of a cluster here in the middle of the map there. Players just trading back and forth.
Yeah, certainly. He went for the reset there. Quite smart. Wait for his team to give him a little bit of support there. And unfortunately, it didn't work in their favour as Textbook Gaming sort of control that spawn there. And look where Armani's spawning. Interesting that he's just sitting here in the yellow window. You think he would push out there because he's not getting the favoured spawn for his team. And as I say that, look where they are spawning in this current stage. If we do jump on board with Tate, who does have that satellite drone, does get tagged up with the EMP. Unfortunately, does miss, as you did say, and Lucifer's just going to go for the reset here.
Yeah, smart move there by Lucifer. He started off quite well, 4-2. Kobe Nate, though, comes flying on in and will clean him up there. Ryzen giving a lot of space here in the middle of the map there. Both of these teams just seem to be running head-on in towards the uplink. They're not really don't really see them focusing too much on, you know, trying to get control of a garage side or a hospital. They just want to run straight down the middle of the map, down the streets, and just rely on raw aim and gun skill. Bacon, however, is showing that he's definitely on point right now. That's going to be his third kill in a row. Make it fourth, actually. There's the fifth of the bomb garage there. And Bacon, good rotations, cheeky little teabag, well deserved.
Yes, certainly, as you've seen, they were able to get a 2-point out of that. So they're currently 2-0 up at this stage. And it looks like Bacon should be able to control these spawns here, as we are still on board with him. Currently going 6-9-2 as the spawns. And we're going to jump on board with Senku. He does get the satellite drone. Does get a little bit of support from Imani. Ooh. Unfortunately, Bacon picks up that two-piece. And Imani's going to be the last one left alive. Does get taken down. Shouldn't have jumped off Bacon there. Picked up a crucial two-piece at the point there. And on an 8-kill streak, he's doing it all for his team at this current stage. Make that a 9. Going for the 10th. Unfortunately, does get taken down. But he was able to get his team a little bit of control there, stop that push from Risen, and get themselves a little bit of composure back in this game.
Yeah, Risen forced into the back of the spawns there. Just Bacon was just controlling the streets, doing a wonderful job there. That's actually going to be a 3 down here. What can they do? Oh, wait, no, Bacon's still alive. This is not an ideal situation if you're on Ryzen. He is just being an absolute thorn in there behind right now. Picks off one player there, spots the second one coming to score, tags him up. There's going to be the assist. The uplink just still in the middle of the map. But it will be still a 4-point advantage to the team of Textbook. Not really seeing much out of Ryzen. Temper, very slow off the mark, only 3-for-3.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, not really getting many contestants at all as we're going to jump over with Lucifer, who does have that satellite drone. One player did jump over him, going for the stomp. Unfortunately, doesn't get the player. That is Brax. He decides to try and throw the satellite drone at him. Didn't connect the player, but Brax contests, and Brax does pick up Lucifer. So some big kills coming out of Brax there. Unfortunately, does get the second kill there, as Senki is going to be pushing through with his satellite drone through the garage, or sorry, the school section. Does have a little bit of support. Needs to get the knife. He does get the knife. Not going to go for the 1-point play. Goes for the 2-point, and he's able to capitalize. And that is 4-2. So some big plays with only a minute and a half left. And some individual plays coming out of Senki there to make the score 4-2, as I said.
Going big when it's needed. Temper now. He has the actual drone in his hand, but he can't make much of it. He really actually hasn't heated up. Expected a lot from him. Getting those 15 catches in the hard point. I'd expect him to do lots of OBJ work. Good job there by Imani, getting a kill. 3 down. Textbook going to be in the back of the spawns. There spots a 4th player. Goes for another stomp here. They just love going for these stumps. They're just raining down on top of the players. And now Imani wants to get that drone into the base of Textbook. Just create more pressure around the map. Now, what can Temper do here? That's not what you need.
That sums up his game, unfortunately. Yep. He's having one of those series that aren't the best, and that exactly says it. Was a little bit unsure which player to shoot for. Should have picked up the original kill, but decided to go for the second one there, as we are on board with Brax. Eventually does pick up the satellite drone, as Julo is able to pick up a two-piece in the background. And they're just going to be pushing through this diner section here with only 26 seconds left. We're going to jump on board with Tates. Let's see whether he's able to get the play. Goes for the throw. There's a few players there. Unfortunately, a little bit short. And some big defense coming out of the play of Risen. And they're just going to go for the reset here. So with 15 seconds left, there's still time for the team of Textbook to get a couple of plays. We will be on with Yulo. See whether he can capitalize on this. Goes for the kills. Unfortunately, does get taken down. And that's going to be a halftime score, 4-2 in favor of the team of Textbook.
Yeah, solid lead there for Textbook. I just want to note that Tate's 10-for-13. He had a fantastic hard point. He ended up dropping 36 kills. All of a sudden, he slowed down a little. Quite interesting to note. He also has missed 2 crucial wall throws. That must be noted. So
are you calling him out, Curry? He's having a little bit of a bad...
I'm just saying what I'm seeing. And Tate's, it's, you know, we see him do an amazing job on the hard point, and then this.
Yeah, certainly. But despite that, his team is doing quite well, as we do see Brax yet again dropping some numbers. Not exactly numbers, but 12 and 10 with a couple of uplinks to his name, as he will be shooting those pre-nades off, trying to get a couple of kills, or the Semtex, I should say. He's going to come in contention with someone going through this pit area. The player is in the window. He's able to pick that up, so he's behind the spawns here. So he should be causing a little bit of havoc for the team of Ryzen, as we will still bring up the minimap there, as Marnie picks up a nice little two-piece, and Yulo is going to be the last one left alive here as his team does spawn up.
Nice.
And Imani picks up another kill there. So he's going extremely well, as we will see what Lucifer can do with his satellite drone.
That's going to be 4 points.
And he should be able to get the pass here, which he does.
Nice.
And a nice little pass towards his teammate there. I believe that was Imani who was able to get the points. And look at Imani. 5 kill streak as he unfortunately does go down. And the team of Textbook are going to go capitalize.
Benny, I don't want to point and focus on the negatives, though, but it's been roughly 4 minutes since Temper has gotten a kill. Not too sure what's going on with him.
Let's give him a little bit of time. See what he is doing.
Let's see
wrong.
What's going on right now with him. And
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, maybe we'll swap players.
He was against Bacon. It must be noted, but that kind of sums up the performance he's having. Hopefully in the final 4 minutes, he can really lift his game. His team do need it. It's only a two-point game. Jula going for a one-man army mission there. Does not work out. And Amani, very good job using the exo ability there. Goes for the reset, and just as a three-down comes down for his team, very well read. And they actually might be able to save this one. Textbook, though, in prime position.
Yeah, certainly, as you said, Textbook are going to be pushing through this school here, and it looks like Brax will have a little bit of control. He should come against a couple of players here in mid-map. Let's see whether they're able to get a couple of score, as we do see him get a couple of shots in hospital. Doesn't pick up the kill, eventually does get the fist on Senki, and he's going to go pushing through this school section here. Decides to throw the satellite drone. He knows there's a player into that school area. Unfortunately, doesn't get the kill. The player will contest him, but Yulo's there to give him a little bit of support, and we do see Lucifer pick up a nice little two-piece there, and we must have missed Temper. He did eventually get a kill there some stage. And we'll jump on board. Ooh, as he picks up another kill there, but Bacon Temper says, I'm going to stop you there, Temper. You've had enough too many kills in this second half here, and we do see Brax get taken down in the meantime.
Yeah, Bacon just doing a wonderful job this game. Tates, I highlighted it at halftime that he wasn't performing too well. Now all of a sudden, he's dropping the 20 kills. Definitely traded it up and living up to what he was doing in the hard point. 2 minutes 40 remaining, still a 2-point game. This game feels like it's been Textbook, you know, dominating them. We're constantly seeing them get all the kills, get the 3 downs, get the 4 downs, but they're just not executing the objective plays enough. They're not getting those 1 points, they're not getting those 2 points and building on that lead. They're getting the kills, but not making anything from it.
Yeah, certainly. And we found that in the hard point. They were slaying, but unfortunately they're, I guess you could say their teamwork. It's just a team thrown together in the last couple of minutes, as we will be able to jump on board with Yolo, who should be able to get the 2-point play as Brax is able to pick up Lucifer there. So nice play with just over 2 minutes left. They stretch that lead out to over 4. And it's one of those games where points are hard to come by. So with a lead of 4, I think it's going to be very difficult for the team of Risen to get back into this, as we are on board with Yolo. Unfortunately, does get taken down by Lucifer, who has picked up a couple of vital kills, but still only 15-23. And as we see, he's on the respawn here. Let's see what he can do.
Ryzen just picked up 2 points there without us even realizing. Congratulations to them. 2-point game once again. Lucifer needs to go big here. Got 3 players. He's already taken out 1. There's a second. 3rd player. We can see him through COD vision, but Lucifer can't. He's just going to grab the ball and just go for it. Player behind him does get dropped. Go for the 1-point play, maybe. No, he's just going to jump around the corner there. Probably wasn't the best of decisions. Amani, though, he picks off 1. That's a 3 down. Temper goes big when it's needed, taking out Bacon. And that's going to be 2 points. Tie game, minute 25. We could be seeing Ryzen actually getting a decent chance here winning this one.
Yeah, certainly. And I called it a little bit earlier. I said points are hard to come by. Just as I say that, 4 points consecutively in favor of the team.
That's 4, though.
But look at Tate's. Yep. 4 down. Just able to go through like that. Nice little two-point play, I should say. And your little spurt to him at halftime is definitely giving him a little bit of extra boost. He's currently going positive now, 22-19. They need to stop this push, as he is able to pick up the 1 kill on the player of Marnie. And that's a big kill there. If he's able to push through, it would have been very difficult, as he does get stunned up heavily. A couple of players in mid there. Does get a couple of shots off. Eventually does pick up the kill there, and big plays coming out of Tates.
45 seconds left. Now, Textbook do have control of that drone, or the ball, should I say. Now, they actually have gone for the reset. Let's see if they can do that again. They have complete control of the wheel map here. Ryzen, they're going to be clutching for straws here. With 30 seconds remaining, here comes a reset. Can Textbook get their hands on it? Throw it on top of Garage. It looks like it won't be. That's actually going to be a two-piece coming in from Senku. And now Temple, what's the ball? Can he go big now? Can he actually redeem himself? He's going to pass it to his teammate. It looks like they're just going to go for it. He jumps over the player and gets the point. 15 seconds remaining. Looks like we were going into overtime.
Yeah, certainly. I wouldn't say that yet, as we will jump on board with Tates, as he's trying to push through. 7 seconds left. The satellite drone, unfortunately, is in favor of Bacon. He goes for the throw, and
he
connects with 1 second
left.
Bacon, the big name player, is able to get the throw and secure the victory, 11-10. And in the dying couple of seconds, big plays coming out of Bacon yet again, picking up those vital two-piece kills consistently through the hard point, and now able to get that final kill. And he went 27-19. We can't take away from the slain he was doing there, and he was able to secure the victory for the team of Textbook, and that makes it 2-0 in a best-of-three series. Curry.
I feel bad now for saying, yeah, we're going into overtime. And then Bacon's like,
no, we're not.
Yeah, sorry, Curry. Good play by him.
Yes.
Very well done by Bacon. Also managed to drop 27 kills and constantly getting those two pieces, as he did in the hard point. Now into a map 3 we will go. Nice advantage for Textbook. Of course, is pool play, meaning we do play out all of the maps in the rotation to get the seeding leading on into day 2 Championship Sunday. But we're still part of here. We're still in Sunday. Still pool play to go. Ryzen, let's discuss that uplink, though. Temper. very shaky performance by him. Wasn't able to get a kill for roughly 3 to 4 minutes.
Yeah, as you said, he was stuck on that three for quite some time. He was 3-3, went to 3-10, I believe it was. So 7 consecutive deaths to him. And they were able to bring it back. They were down 8-4. They were able to actually take the lead, I believe, at some stage there, 10-8. But Textbook Gaming were able to secure the victory again as we are jump onto a search and destroy on Biolab. So as we did say, Textbook Gaming have got the victory 2-0, but being poor play, we need to play this through.
It'll be interesting to see how Bacon plays this. We do see him constantly being aggressive, challenging rooms, getting those two pieces. Can he do that in a game mode such as Search and Destroy where, you know, player skill really can actually win the team a map there? And after that little clutch by him in the uplink, I wouldn't be surprised. First Blood, however, does fall for Imani, taking out Tate, so that's a good start for Ryzen.
Yeah, certainly, as you see, Yulo be able to pick up the kill there in return. So, currently got a 3v3 situation. Bacon's just playing a little bit slow through snow as Brax is able to pick up Temper in the background. So, it's going to be Senki and Lucifer in a 2v3 situation. It looks like the bomb's going to be pushing this B-bomb site. And they're just looking for that little pick before they push through. As Bacon's just pushing outside, Senki goes down. So, we're left in a 1v3. Lucifer in a 1v3 situation. We will jump on board with him as he does spot one through mid by Lab, and unfortunately does get taken down. And I believe if he took that kill, he would have pushed through that to the bomb site and potentially be able to take him off bomb, but unfortunately it wasn't the case. Brax was able to get the turn on, and Brax and Yulo both picked up two kills themselves, so he was red.
Yeah.
So big kill coming out of Brax, so unfortunately Lucifer wasn't able to pick up the kill there, and first round going in favour of Textbook.
They managed to get first blood, couldn't capitalise on it, especially on the defensive round, so that's a perfect start for Textbook picking off the offensive, especially on Biolab where you would just see teams usually get constant defensive rounds. Let's watch Lucifer. Let's see what he can do this round for his team. Looks like they want to be pushing this B hard bomb. Yeah. Nice and hard and fast, but they get tagged, so they know there's someone roughly in the vicinity. They're pushing on in here. Lucifer not getting much support for his teammate. That's going to be Senku drop in first blood, though.
Yeah, as you said, they push through hard, but they play passive. Lucifer, unfortunately, does get tags up there. Player's going to be pushing through mid, and now he's left alone in a 1v4 situation. And the players were aware of where he was, and unfortunately does get taken down. But unusual play coming out of the team there. They all were in the one room, and they were easily taken down from there as the team at Textbook just pushed them through. As we do see Bacon picking up the final kill, and three players on the team of Textbook yet to get a death.
Yeah, Textbook, they just gave up control of the B-bomb site, that whole purple area, and then just broke it. Very peculiar, a little bit abstract way to play the defensive side of Biolab, but it seems to be working. Julo, he's got the scope in, wants to try and get first blood. Oh, that's a beautiful shot. Can he get the second? He does. Julo, wonderful there as he gets the first two kills. Can he get a third? There's going to be a player lurking around him. He knows that he's...
I'm not entirely sure. So maybe a controller died.
I don't know what's worse. The Xbox fact that Julo's maybe like, yeah, probably. The fact that Julo was standing still, or that Senku missed that many bullets on a target standing still.
Yeah, well, exactly right. A little bit unfortunate. I think, as you said, Julo going 6-0 does get taken down there. So the good old Xbox record didn't work in his favour, I believe, or either the controller died. So we got left in a 2v3 situation. Senki and Lucifer left alone here as we do see Senki just pushing through this bomb site as the bomb is planted over at A. So obviously they've got to take down three attackers here for the team of Textbook Gaming. Now Bacon does take down Lucifer. Okay. Senki's able to take down Bacon, so he's left in a 1v2 situation.
Make that
0v2.
Oh.
What play got from behind?
Yeah, he was just watching him. He was just stalking him. See, look, Braxton.
A little bit of a teabag there too, so...
Only on the main stage.
Yeah, exactly.
Of course.
Right. I mean, they've won the series here, so they can play pretty confidently.
It's pool play though, so does anybody actually win the series? Because it's all about maps.
Yeah, certainly, but I guess you want to clear out that three...
I'm just trying to think positively. 3-0.
I mean, 3-0, they're 3 down here at the moment. So, or 3-0 up, I should say, in favour of Textbook.
They need this round, desperately. They need to slow that momentum, otherwise they're going to be going into a 4-0 defensive side, which probably will get broken by Textbook, by the way that they're playing. Their shots are just on point compared to Ryzen. First Blood comes in favour of them. Then a two-piece, actually. Julo answering back there now. Senku did actually get the tags on. So there's a player around his vicinity. Doesn't want to scope it out or check it out, and... Braxton actually tries to go for a bit of a cheeky little play there. Actually gets a two. No, he doesn't. Outgunned in the end there. Braxton, he's been a little bit cheeky. They might have cost him in that one, though.
Yeah, certainly. As you said, he was going to originally go for the ninja defuse, but the player did spot him coming up to the bomb site there. A little bit unfortunate, not picking up the final kill there, as Marnie was tagged up. But he was able to get the final kill and currently going on a 3-kill streak. And that was the round that you said they needed to get back. So currently 3-1 in favour of Textbook Gaming. But it's good to see Imani finally get around. And you know what? We're going to stay with them. Stay with the defensive team. See what they are doing. And Imani is on a 3-kill streak. So we'll stay with him, see what he can do. And looks like he's going to get contested here. It looks like, look at the push see at the mini-map here.
Oh, no.
Don't contest the scope, Imani. You will get taken your head off there.
They've stacked B and Textbook have gone A. That's an unlucky gamble. It was a 50-50. Doesn't seem like it's worked out quite well for them, and the numbers are in favour of Textbook. Long-range engagements here. They've got to watch out for the scopes there now. Imani knows there's someone on the bomb. Actually tags him up. Sees the player EXO above him. So lots of information coming through. And the bomb does go down. Still no one has actually dropped. It is a 3v3 situation. Stun grenade comes out. Hits Bacon right on the head there. Now, can he actually use that to his advantage? Very aggressively pushing out. Braxton drops. Bacon gets a kill too. And just like that, Textbook able to hold out the bomb site.
Yeah, as you said, just like that, within probably a couple of seconds, three players for the team have risen, were taken down. As we see, Bacon pick up one, pick up the two-piece final kill cam on Lucifer. And guess what? Bacon, two-piece. Does that sound familiar at all, Curry?
Yeah, that's basically been Bacon's story throughout this series. I'm just not too sure what Lucifer was doing. He grapples into the room and then turns around.
Yeah, I believe a player was shooting in blue there, so he decided to contest there, but unfortunately, not the right timing for him. And we're going to stay on board with Imani, see what he can do. He does have that bomb in hand. And look at Lucifer, 0-5, as Imani is able to pick up that first kill there. So we'll see what Lucifer is doing wrong as we do jump on board with him as the bomb decides to go down. Just watching mid and wire lap here, as one player will be contesting him here, but it, unfortunately, a bit of timing as bomb does go down. 40 seconds remaining. It's 2v4, Bacon and Brax up against the remaining team of Risen.
Yeah, the two players from Textbook are just miles away from each other right now, and you actually do see Brax, he's pushing in on the opposite side here, missing a lot of shots. He actually deserves to die in that situation. Imani punishes him and actually gets the two-piece well read by him, and that's what I want to see by Ryzen. I want to see them actually winning rounds and getting kills on the board, aiming that at you, Lucifer. Imani, though, nice little two-piece there, reading it extremely well, instantly onto the final player there.
Yeah, certainly some good accuracy coming out of Imani. And as you said, on a 3-kill streak at this current stage. But Lucifer really needs to pick up his game if they want to secure this search and destroy, as he is currently going 0-5. But look at the other side. Textbook Tates, 1-3, mate. Curry called you out earlier. I'm going to call you out now. You need to pick up your game, buddy. Unfortunate timing for him as he decides to throw his stun, does get taken down. And that's the caster's curse coming at you right there, Textbook Tates. So favour going in favour of Ryzen as they are 3v2 situation here. As look at Tempo, he's just getting a little bit aggressive. Playing pretty confidently, pushing through the base here. As he's going to get spotted up from Brax, but he knows where the player is at least. Sorry, that will be Bacon, my apologies. And he's going to call that out to his team. Wisely decides to back up as sees a player push through ice, gets turned on. And now look at that, Imani is left in a 1v2 situation. Quickly from a 3v2 to a 1v2.
And he knows there's a player there too. He's actually heard him. Bacon's got to be really careful right now. Imani, he's just going to be trying to find out, trying to scope out the player. Does find him, so it's a one-on-one. Can he clutch up once again? 5-kill streak, trying to make it 6. He's going to be heading towards the B bomb site. Doesn't actually spot the player that plants. He's just going to decoy an EXO around. Tries to bait out a few shots there. Spots the player leaving the actual building. And he's just actually going to try and maybe chase it. Doesn't seem like he wants to. Now, Julo, he's got to pull out the scope there. Misses the shot, though. And now with 30 seconds left, is he just going to hold it? He's going to stick it, and it doesn't work out. That actually would have been really close to being defused.
It was defused.
It was? Oh, he got it.
4-3, bomb defused. So,
that was close.
That was some choky shots there, though. Ooh. He decided to get out of the scope. And smart play coming out of the team from Ryzen there.
It was a bit questionable by Julo. Plants it on the opposite side and then runs to scope when the player's got protection from the bomb. Maybe not a strategy fully thought out there by Julo. Now, we did watch Tate. That's a cheeky little spot. We did watch him in the previous round. Got dropped instantly. In comes the EMPs. They know that there's a few players in there. He's not going to be jumping around anytime, so he gives away his location, trying to hit fire around the corner there. That's going to be first blood. Lucify gets a kill. No longer on the donut. Temper comes in and gets a second one. There's a third one for Imani, and Brax answers back with a kill of his own, but this should be a round. Should be a round. For the team of Ryzen, but Braxton could clutch this.
He's going to go for the 1v4. Obviously got the first two kills there. Was tagged up. Decides to back off wisely. Regen his health here as the bomb is going down. So he's going to know where the player is. Does spot that player there. But unfortunately, they do the trade. And 4-4. Ooh. Team of Risen are actually bringing this back here. And as you said, Lucifer got off that that donut, but he's bringing out the breadstick now. 1-7.
Hey, a breadstick's better than a donut. Okay.
Well, I'd rather a donut personally, but... speak for yourself there, Curry. But yeah, as you said, 4-4 at this current stage, and Risen are actually bringing themselves back in this. We will jump on board with the attacking team, and I want Tates to pick up his game a little bit.
Yeah, I don't see him doing it, though, because he always pushes towards this B site and just gets killed instantly. I would actually like to see Julo, because he's actually getting some really good shots with the scope. Maybe he's going to whip it out here towards the B side. He's actually going to be aggressively pushing now. He did spot the player. So lots of information for him. The player is actually going to be around the elbow there, but he pulls out Temper, draws first blood, taking out Braxton. There goes Tate, 1-6. Not ideal for him, as Senku actually picks that one up now. Julo, he actually spots a lot of players there, but doesn't know which one to go for. Cost him in the end there. Bacon, he does have the bomb, though, making the best of a bad situation, but still three players from Ryzen to contest, and he is dead. Ryzen, just like in the series against True Ambition, might actually walk away with a map here.
Yes, certainly. As you said, a few little mistakes early on in these couple of rounds from the team of Textbook Gaming. Been a little bit confident, and the team have risen. They're actually bringing this back, as we see Senki picking up the final kill cam there. And I believe Amani's going 10-6, so he's playing extremely well. Picking up the slack for the team of Lucifer, who's currently going 1-8. You know what, I'm going to jump on board with him, see what he's doing wrong.
All right.
Do you reckon he's doing the same push as Tate's, pushing through mid-biolab here? No, he's not. So he's going to play through yellow here, so he's going to play a little bit passive, but let's see whether he's able to get a kill or not. He's just playing pretty slow. Not too much happening with him at the moment. Throws his stuns over there, see whether he can connect with the player. He's going to be pushing through. There will be a couple of players drop for each team. And now Lucifer spots the play, gets a couple of tags out, does pick up the kill. Now it's a 2v2 situation. Lucifer off that donut, or breadstick, as I should say.
Yep.
So it's Temper and Lucifer up against Brax and Julo.
Redemption. This is redemption for Temper's performance in the uplink. If he can clutch up here, does have the bomb. And this is redemption for Lucifer, dropping the 2-8. But they do have to take out Brax and Julo, who both their shots are on point right now. We saw Julo get that two-piece earlier in the S&D. Wonderful job by him. Just one round away, Ryzen R from actually taking this one. They've actually slowed it down a lot. 35 seconds remaining. They're going to group up now. Looks like they're going to try and go for an execute onto one of the bomb sites here. And Temper, he's just going to run with the knife out there. It looks like they're just going to not actually spot the player, but breaking the glass gives away his location. 20 seconds. He's got to get this bomb down. Here come the players, though, from Textbook. Lucifer has to defend the bomb planter here. Otherwise, he's going to be a sitting duck there, and that's what's going to happen right there. Can he get one kill? The second player, 11 seconds. They're just going to run from this situation. This should be a round for the team of Textbook.
Yeah, but as you say that, he's able to get the bomb down. Brax decides to run away. And so we're left to a good 1v1. Brax up against Lucifer, who was currently 1-7 or 1-8. So he's got a couple of kills this round, and he's starting to turn it up. Make that two kills, as Curry points that out to me, so my ass isn't too crash hot. And looks like Brax is just playing a little bit passive here, looking at all corners, trying to pick up that kill. And smart play from Lucifer, not allowing him to actually spot him.
Braxton leaving that bomb just opened up the... tons of opportunities for Lucifer to hide out, and now he's searching for the player there. He knows the bomb is on that side, but he's not actually going to spot Lucifer. Lucifer actually comes around the left side there, uses the canister to his advantage, but good clutch there by Lucifer. I'm actually going to redeem him with that one. Very well done. Got the three kills in the end there and managed to clutch up when his team needed it. That will be one map for Ryzen in the overall series score. Still a victory for Textbook. They get two important maps to add to their pool play tally.
Yes, certainly, as you said, they were able to secure a 2-1 victory out of best of three. But yet again, Risen, they were able to secure that search and destroy 6-4, and I believe it was the same score as previously. So they were able to close out that search and destroy. Obviously, Textbook had a very strong start there. I think they were 4-0 up. And six consecutive rounds going in favor of Risen. And some questionable plays coming out of the team of Textbook there. But despite that,
questionable, you mean Tate's.
Yeah, Tate struggled a little bit there. We will point him out. 1-7. He played extremely well in one of the previous games. I believe it was a hard point. But from there on, it just went downhill.
It was both of them. He did extremely well off the break in the hard point. And then in the uplink, I criticized him at halftime and then just bang, straight into it.
But we did that in the search and destroy, and he didn't listen to us.
Yeah, he didn't listen to it. Damn it, Tate.
A little bit sentimental there. But as you said, nice little victory going in favor of the team of Textbook Gaming 2-1. We're going to go to a quick commercial break, and we'll be back soon, guys.